Hi, I'm George Hirsch. Welcome to George Hirsch Lifestyle. Now we're going to actually start things from the ground up, because the eastern part of Long Island was really known for its farms, and potato farms in particular, especially years ago. What's gained a lot of popularity is a Yukon potato. What I like about it is it's very, very sweet, it's mealy, it's very versatile, so you can use it for a lot of dishes, frying, steaming, baking, as well as what I'm doing today, which kind of prepared a lot, is like a mashed potato, or I'm calling it my mousseline potatoes, where I'm going to use the Yukon and also garlic, a good amount of garlic in this recipe. So for the Yukon potatoes, I have a large pot, about 4 cups of potatoes that have been simmering, and just enough water that covered the potatoes. I didn't want to have them in too much water that they begin to disintegrate and I lose that earthiness in the potato taste. And the best way of checking a potato if it's done is either use a fork method or a paring knife like I have here and use the bite test. What you want to do is you want to have it very, very soft and that it presses all the way through. Not that it's al dente like pasta. So we're just gonna let these go about another 2 minutes. I'll bring up some chicken stock that I've actually steeped with some cloves of garlic to give it a nice garlic flavor. Now, I know a lot of people, when you're used to mashed potatoes, you have butter, you have heavy cream, half and half, or milk. This is actually a nice non-dairy alternative without sacrificing any of the flavor. I've served this many occasions and even on a lot of dinner parties, and you're gonna see this is something you can even prepare the day ahead, because it's actually better when you make it yesterday and you lay it out in the pan and just have it ready to go as your guests arrive. So I'm going to take the potatoes and just strain them off, bring them back over to the stove a moment. And I didn't turn the burner off, I left the burner on, and you can see all the steam that's just coming up out of the top. I want to get some of the excess moisture out of those potatoes so it doesn't become too watery. I want the flavor from the broth actually to flavor these potatoes. So I'm just going to do a quick mash. So once you have a good mash on the potato, I'll add in a couple tablespoons of olive oil. Again, not sacrificing any of the flavor. Give that a little bit of a mash inside. Drizzle about a half a cup of chicken broth to start with. And remember, the chicken broth was infused with garlic. Some finely chopped garlic infused and then strained off. Put in another cup of chicken broth now. Now what I want to add in is a small amount of cheddar cheese, about 1/4 cup of cheddar cheese, about 1 tablespoon of Parmesan cheese. I'll add in some fresh ground black pepper. Drizzle a little more olive oil just to help the cheese melt in. Fresh herbs go really well inside of potatoes. You know, a potato doesn't have much flavor of its own. It's basically everything that you put inside there. If you wanted to make a little bit of a meat version of this, you could use little pieces of ham, of course, a little pancetta. Put in my chives. And what I'll do now is just lightly grease with a little olive oil, an oven-proof ramekin. Put them in my ramekin. And I like to make a few ripples on top of the potatoes This way has a chance for the extra cheese. Some sharp cheddar cheese, a little extra Parmesan. Drizzle a small amount more of olive oil on top. And now you can take and put it in the broiler, or I'll put it in a salamander on a very high heat. If you made this a day ahead, what you would want to do is put it in a 350 oven for about 20-25 minutes. But we're going to put this in the salamander or under a broiler on a very, very hot temperature, only for about 2 minutes. Let's just try a sample now that it's still nice and hot and bubbly. Give the mousseline potatoes a try. You'll be glad you did. I'm George Hirsch. Remember, if I can do it, you can do it. See you next time. For more on recipes, entertaining lifestyle tips, TV series blog, and selected video clips from today's show, join me at chefgeorgehirsch.com.